We have been gifted here at the Stranahan House with a beautiful collection of Christopher Radko ornaments that came from a lady by the name of Mary Porter. And when she passed away, they were left to the Stranahan House. So Flowers and Found Objects has come over and decorated the house with all those gorgeous ornaments. And they're all really keepsake, very unusual individual numbered ornaments. So we have a very special group of ornaments to put together for the house decorations each year.
Hi. Welcome to our Victorian parlor this evening at the beautiful Stranahan House. I'm here to give you some customs and how our traditions actually started and when they started. First traditions that I'm going to talk about this evening are our ornaments. If you have an angel on the top of your tree, it means that God is present. A piece of fruit means bountiful harvest. An evergreen is that we are going to have a wonderful fresh new year. We have also Saint Nicholas on our tree, and Saint Nicholas would mean that there's love in the home. But there is a few special ornaments that we celebrate also, and I'm going to point out, this is the first one that I'm going to talk about. It's called a pickle ornament. Well, the pickle ornament is placed on the tree by the very last person that goes to bed. Usually, it's the mother in the family. And it is hidden quite nicely on the tree. And in the morning, the very first thing, everyone in the home runs downstairs to find the pickle ornament. And that is because the person that finds it is guaranteed a fresh, beautiful new year and a lot of happiness that year. And of course, you receive an extra special gift also. Our spider ornaments are a symbol of someone that had very little money in those days. And the story goes that this woman had no money to buy ornaments for her beautiful tree. And she went and just put the tree up anyway and went to bed. And the beautiful spiders that were in the home decided that she needed a sparkling tree. So during the night, when everyone was asleep, the spiders wove the magical webbing all around the tree with sparkly, almost like a glistening gold all throughout the tree. And that's why we have the magic of the spider ornament. The candle that we leave, the one candle in the window, that was put there so that people would not have any spirits come into the home on Christmas Eve. And at midnight, they would open all the doors and the windows and yell out, "Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night." And the reason they opened all the doors and windows was to let out any spirits that were behind from the year before, and they would have a fresh start to the new year on Christmas Eve.
I want to tell you a story about the peppermint pig. This was first devised in Sarasota, New York, in the late 1890s. And after people had had such a big meal, and they had many, many things. They had turkey, but they had roast beef and a whole pig, so many things. So when the dinner was finished, we put this pig inside this little bag. And then you take the hammer and you pound off a piece. And as you're doing this, you share a item of good fortune that happened to you during the year. It might be a new job or a new baby in the family. But then it was passed around and everyone had a chance to tell this story and also have a taste of peppermint pig.
Because we're sure that Ivy and Frank must have celebrated Christmas in a very special way, because this town was important to them and the Christmas celebration would have been important to them too.